Hello, sport fans. Welcome to Sport Roundup on SmileTime Africa with SmileTime Baba. My name is Bayonle Arashi from Millennium Broadcasting Channel in Houston, Texas, USA, bringing you the latest information happenings in the world of sport in just 3 minutes. As you already know that the biggest sport event is happening currently in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. It's big, it's huge, it is the Olympics. And of course, so many world records being broken, so many history being made at the Rio Olympics. Not been so good for African athletes in the Olympics, but not bad as well. We have an African team in the medal region for the football sport, of course. And of course, we had one of the best week ever. South African man, 24-year-old Van Niekerk, that won gold medal in the world, breaking world record that has been there for 17 years. 17-year-old record broken by that young man. I'm very excited, so don't mind me. It's such a very big honor. And that was not the only thing for this young South African. The second thing is, he is the only man that has won that particular race running from lane 8 of that particular sport. It's always very difficult to run and win from that particular angle. If you are an athlete, I'm sure you know what I am talking about, as if that is not enough for that young man from South Africa. He's also being trained by his great grandmother. That is it. Let me say it again. Great grandmother, 74-year-old Hans Bott is his trainer. The woman has been training athletes since the 1960s. So this is a very exciting one for Africa, and of course for us all as lover of sport across the world. That is just for it, for that South African man winning his gold medal on the Monday. And of course, you know, Usain Bolt, the fastest man in the world, he also created another record-breaking event, becoming the triple Olympian, of course, winning 3 gold medals in the 100 meters back to back in 3 Olympics. That means in 12 years, he has been the best and the fastest man the world has ever seen. And I'm not sure anyone will break that record in anytime soon at all. Mo Farah, our African brother, also, of course, running for Great Britain now, also became a triple Olympic champion, winning, of course, his own third title as well. Gold it was for us for Great Britain as well in that particular one. So many good things happening to Africans, of course, across the world. It is still Sports Roundup on SmileTime Africa. And of course, you know, the most glamorous football league in the world, the English Premier League, kicked off over the weekend with some very exciting results. Of course, the three biggest teams, I don't want to offend no one now, because Arsenal is also a big team, and I'm sure a lot of people would agree with me, even though they've had a very bad time in the past. And of course, it looks like it's going to be one of those seasons again for them this season, losing 4-3 at home to Liverpool in their first game. That is for Arsenal. Now, Jurgen Klopp and his boys went to Emirates to defeat Arsenal in their first league game of the season by 4-3. Of course, Chelsea has a new boss in Antonio Conte, and of course, he also celebrated his first game at home at Stamford Bridge with a 2-1 hard-fought victory over West Ham United. Of course, Manchester United also have a new boss in the special one himself, Jose Mourinho, winning away at Bournemouth 3-1. Of course, his stars also making their presence known, Zlatan Ibrahimovic scoring a goal for himself, captain Wayne Rooney also scoring another one, and the player that had some issue with Mourinho at Chelsea, and of course, still having it at the Old Trafford now, Juan Mata actually opening the scoring sheet for Manchester United. Of course, let's go straight to the Etihad Stadium. Manchester City also having another genius in the box, Pep Guardiola also winning his own first game at home, 2-1 as well. So exciting times await all the sport fans in the sporting world come this season. This is about the little I will be able to bring to you today on Sports Roundup on SmileTime Africa. Until I come your way again next week, I could be followed on any of my social media platforms as Midas Soccer. At Midas Soccer is as simple as that. My name is Bayonle Arashi. See you guys again next week. God bless you all. I love you. Bye bye now.